Welcome to Packet Tracer Subnetting Example, guys. In the subnetting example, we will focus on a real-life subnetting example, and we will do this on Cisco Packet Tracer. If you are ready to solve this subnetting question, let's go. Here we have an IP block 50.5.10.0/24. With this IP block, we can have 254 available host addresses, 256 available addresses, and 254 host addresses. Here we have four departments. First department is engineering department. It needs 120 hosts. Second department is accounting department, and it needs 40 hosts. Third one is HR, 20 hosts. And last one is management department. It needs 10 hosts. We cannot use our block for only one of them. Here we need subnetting for efficient IP address assignment. Firstly, let's check the highest need. The highest need is in engineering department, and it needs 120 hosts. To cover 120 hosts, we need to divide our IP block into two. Because let me show you. This is our IP address. So when we need 120 hosts, we need to have this block. 2 to the 7 is 128. So to have 128, we need 7 host bits. And to have 7 host bits, we need /25. So here we will do this /25, and the second one is 50.5.10.128/25. These are our new two blocks. So we will use the first block for this 120 hosts. So here for this IP address, we will have 128 address. The first one will be network address, and the last one will be broadcast address. And in the middle, 126 addresses will be host addresses. And we can use 120 addresses, and the remaining 6 addresses will be wests. It is not important for this question. So here, the first block is this. Then we have this block, the second block. So the second one is the accounting part, and for the accounting part, I will write our remaining addresses here again. This is our remaining part. So to cover this host, we need 2 to the 5. So no, 2 to the 5 is 32, so we cannot cover this one. So 2 to the 6 is equal to 64, and for 64 hosts, we need 6 host bits. For 6 host bits, we need /26. So here, let me change this one. And the second one will be 50.5.10. And let's add 64 to this one. We'll find 192. These are our two blocks, /26. These are our two new blocks, and we will use this block for 40 hosts. So normally, let's see, we have 64 address. One is network, one is broadcast, and 62 host addresses. And we have 40 hosts here, so it is okay for this network. The other addresses will be west, but it is not important again. So here we have this IP address. 50.5.10.192. So here we need 20 hosts. To reach 20 hosts, 2 to the 4 is equal to 16, 2 to the 5 is equal to 13. So we need 5 host bits. To reach 5 host bits, we need slash 27. So we will do this 27, and the second one will be, let's add 32, 4, yes, this is the second one. The first one is this one, and the second one is this one, slash 27. So with this block, again, we will have 32 address, one network, one broadcast, and 30 host addresses. And here we need 20 host addresses, and we can give IP addresses up to 30 hosts, so it is okay. So our remaining block is here. 50.5.10.224. So here we need 10 hosts. So to reach 10 hosts, we need 2 to the 4 is equal to 16. So we need 4 host bits. And for 4 host bits, we need slash 28. So we'll do this 28. And also the second one will be, let's add 240/28. Yes, this is our new IP range. The first one will be used again here. And our remaining block is this one. So what will we do with this remaining block? Here we have 4 different departments, as you can see, but we have also some point-to-point links here. So we will use these IP blocks on these point-to-point blocks. So let's write our range again. 50.5.10.240/28. So for point-to-point links, we need slash 30. It is generally used between point-to-point links. So to have slash 30, we need to divide this 4 different subnets. So let's write the first one again. This is the first one, slash 30, and we will add this 4, then it is 245. We will add again 248, and lastly 252. These are our new slash 30 blocks. So we will use this first block here. The second block will be here, and the third block will be here. Yes, we have finished our subnetting, and we have efficiently used our IP block for these 4 different departments. Yes, guys, we have finished our real-life subnetting example on Packet Tracer. If you like this video, do not forget to like and share with your friends. And also, do not forget to subscribe to our channel. Good luck!